purchases are the costs you incur in order to run your business. While you can also track indirect non-material costs in Craftybase, today we'll be focusing on how to enter material purchases into your account. For small manufacturers, material purchasing and usage is one of your biggest costs, so it's important to track this accurately. By adding material purchases in Craftybase, you'll be able to automatically track your material stock levels and calculate your exact unit costs. Let's get started. Let's say we just purchased some red buttons. To record this in Craftybase, we'll click the Add Purchase button in the right-hand corner to go to the purchase form. Here, we'll say we purchased these buttons 2 days ago. Next, we'll enter the supplier's invoice number for this purchase so we have a unique ID for the purchase. Now, we'll add some vendor details about the business that sold the buttons. This is our vendor. As we've purchased from this company before, they will appear in the search box. If this was a new vendor, we could add their details by clicking the plus button on the right-hand side of the box. On to the purchase details. Under the Purchase Line Items heading, let's click the Add Purchase Item button to add our line item. As this is a purchase of a material, we will want to select Materials as our category. This is a special purchase category that ensures that the purchase is added to our inventory correctly and included in our COGS, or Cost of Goods Sold. Now, we'll find our button material by typing in the material box. If we didn't already have this material in our inventory, we could have also added the material by clicking the Add New Material button. This will now display a couple of new fields. We'll enter 100 under our tracking quantity box, as this is how much we purchased. You'll see that the unit costs will already be pre-filled based on your material record. We'll enter what we paid for these 100 buttons under the total cost. This will calculate the cost per button for us automatically. As we picked up the buttons directly from the store, we'll leave the received checkbox ticked. This will mean that our button inventory will be increased when we save this purchase. For our example, you can see that before the purchase of 100, we had 25 buttons in stock. So the new quantity available after this purchase is 125. We'll now click on Add Purchase Item. Discounts, shipping, and tax can be added here. Any discounts and shipping we paid for the entire purchase will be factored into our material unit costs proportionately. Our grand total now calculates to $15.70. This purchase has already been paid for, so we'll leave the paid checks box ticked. Now, we'll save the purchase. Here is our new purchase record for our button purchase. Let's take a quick look at the material to see how it's increased our button inventory. We now have 125 buttons available in our inventory, and our unit cost has now been recalculated to include this purchase. Thanks so much for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, please feel free to get in touch with us.